So, dear students, we were doing a very beautiful chapter, The Bond of Love. Okay, up to which paragraph we have done? Okay, up to 20th we have done. Okay, so finally, what was the decision which was taken? Because when they both were found fretting, on one hand, narrator's wife was fretting. She was feeling uneasy, worried for that bear. And another hand, bear was also fretting. So he was also worried. He was not taking anything. He was also sad. He wanted to meet her. So finally, the decision was taken that they wrote a letter to the concerned authority. Okay. And their consent was agreed and decision was taken that beer should be given back to them. So for that, it was not so easy to bring that beer to their house because it was so huge in size. So finally, the decision was taken that one of the lorry was arranged, a big cage was kept on that. Okay, such kind of arrangements were made. Because it was not a shorter distance, it was a very long distance, and moreover, very heavy cage was kept on the top of a car. So that's why it had to be driven very safely, very slowly. Okay, so finally, when it was this decision was taken and it was sent back to their house. Now they both were happy. Narrator's wife was also happy and bear was also happy because they both were again united in the same house where he was earlier living. He spent his childhood in that. And narrator's wife treated that animal not like an animal. She treated him just like her son, her own baby. So that's why there was a sweet bond of love between that animal and a human being, which was witnessed by everybody. Now, condition of narrator wife was also okay, and condition of that Baba was also okay. He started eating everything. He became normal, but for the past 3 months, he was missing and he was not eating anything. He was fretting, unhappy. Clear? So, Yug, you read paragraph number 21.
Once home, a squad police were engaged for special...
We have done that 21, sorry. 22.
In a few days, the police hoisted the cage onto the island and Baba was released. He was delighted standing on his hind legs. He pointed his gun and dragged his baby. My wife spent hours sitting on a chair there while he sat on her lap. He was 15 months old and pretty heavy too. The way my wife reaches the island and leaves, it is interesting. I have tied a rope to the overhanging branch of a mango tree with a loop at its end. Putting one foot in the loop, she kicks off with the other to bridge the 6-foot gap that constitutes the width of the surrounding pit. The return journey is made the same way. But who can say now that a sloth bear has no sense of affection, no money, and no individual...
No memory. So basically what happened, they had to hire some of the coolies, and because of the help of that coolies, they were able to keep that big cage on that island also. Because what did island, basically not like ocean kind of island, but there was a big ocean and island. Island means a different aloof place, which was just like a raised platform. Okay, big one. So that was released. Okay, he was so happy and he was standing on his hind legs. Hind legs means, you can say, two legs. okay, and he pointed his gun and cradled his baby, okay, and such kind of activity was going on. Narrator's wife, she used to spend so many hours sitting on a chair. And that Baba, he used to sit in the lap of narrator's wife. Okay. Now, what was the age of that Baba? Now, he was near about 15 months old. But now, its weight also increased. It has become heavy also. Okay. So the way my wife reaches the island and leaves, it is interesting. So the way when they were reaching at the island, it was so interesting because now he had to tie a rope, okay, because there was already a mango tree. So he tied a rope with that mango tree and there was a loop. Loop, you can say, the portion of that tree which was rounded, which was folded, okay. So one foot in the loop was kept and another she kicks off with the other to bridge the 6 foot gap, okay. That was, you can say, constituting the width of the surrounding pit. So the return journey was also like that. It means if anybody wants to go on that island, how they were going, and when they have to come from that island, they have to go through the same process. Okay. But now who can say that such kind of sloth bear, he was not having a sense of affection? No, he was having, he understood the love. Okay, and who could say that he was not having memory, because their friends were making guesses, they were making opinion that bear would not be able to recognize. Now their opinion proved wrong, because that animal had a great memory and he was having its own individual characteristics. Okay. So we can say the affection between that sloth bear and narrator's wife, it was just like a symbol of true love. It can be considered as a symbol of true love. Okay. So this story shows us that animals, they also have love feelings. They also love. Okay. They express their feelings. Who love them? They express their feelings to them who give them love. So there are so many qualities of Baba that resembles like the qualities of a human being. Which kind of qualities are like that? Love, affection, care. Okay. So we can say they both shared love. They both shared bond of love. Clear? So now let's discuss question answers. Given in the box are some of the headings. So you find the relevant paragraph in the text to match the heading. Suppose this paragraph is given, this caption is given, an orphaned cub. So which paragraph will be suited for that? If I want to give caption to any of the paragraph, Hardur is not serious in my class. Jaskirat is his best friend. For him, everything is Jaskirat. This study doesn't matter to him. Jaskirat and Hardur, both of you sit separate. Within 1 second, all of you go through your books and find out Caption can be given to which paragraph? Yes. An orphan cub. Bruno's food chart. Very quick. You have already purchased, I think, old notebooks. The answers are written. Old books. An accidental case of poisoning. Playful Baba. No. Playful Baba. Pain of separation.
नन्हे लगाई वहां से मैं चुजे बैठ गया हूँ
14 joy of reunion joy of reunion 21 joy of reunion go through it again carefully yes 16th paragraph a request to the zoo A request to the zoo. An island.
18th.
So you are supposed to do this question only in your books. Only for practice it is given. Now answer the following question. I got him for her by accident. Who says this? Very simple narrator. So Arzu, you tell me three parts of first question.
क्यों मैंने इसको क्या बोला ये ज्यादा खींचती मैंने इसको पता सुनो अब मैंने क्या बोला इसको
Yes. Yes, Arzu. Him refers to little sloth bear and her refers to narrator's wife. Yes, your answer is right. Next. Which incident is being described here? Referred here it is given in passive form because is this given so it has become in passive form yes Divya
the incident referred to when orphan cub was given to his wife
You have to tell in short, beta. Don't pick up bookish language. Tell in one or two lines only. In short, which incident is being described, Manshika? Mysore. Shooted is a word. Shot. When mother bear was shot and sloth bear was left alone. Okay. So this incident is being described, referred here. Simple one line. Why you make things so complicated and you tell me a long tale, long story? I will find from that. Okay, he stood on his head in delight. Last girl.
Mm-hmm.
when he met him after a very such a long period of time, you can write down also, near about 3 months. We all missed him greatly, but in a sense, we all were relieved. Relieved means relaxed. So you tell me this answer. Hey, why? Stand up. नहीं आता. This is the answer I'm getting after explaining each and every line of the chapter. कितने आराम से लोग बोल देते हैं नहीं आता. He will be telling, otherwise he will stand. Jaskirat, you come here and sit at first desk. Come here. Come here, I am going to discuss answers with you. Now let me see what you are doing. Yes, Yug. Yes. We all, who are we all? Yes, we all means the narrator and his wife. It means whole family is being conceived. Whole family, you can see. Yes. Whom did they miss?
Baba.
हाँ तो तुमने कैसे बोल दिया इसका आंसर मुझे नहीं आता. हाँ नेक्स्ट. इन्होंने ये क्यों बोला कि नाउ वी आर मिसिंग हिम बट वी आर रिलीव्ड. हम रिलैक्स हैं. क्यों रिलैक्स हो गए वो? नो नो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन हिज कॉमन सेंस. व्हाई वर दे फीलिंग रिलैक्स्ड? हाँ तो स्पीक इन इंग्लिश दिस थिंग. नाइन्थ में पढ़ते हो ना? बुलाऊं फोर्थ का बच्चा कोई? मैं बुलाऊंगी अब. लिसन बेटा, बाहर से लड़की निकल रही, उसको बुलाऊं? नहीं नहीं आना. नाइन्थ के हो? मैं फोर्थ का बच्चा बुलाऊंगी. विल बी फ्रेमिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. इट विल बी अ ग्रेट इंसल्ट. आई डोंट वांट टू शाउट एंड वेस्ट माय एनर्जी लाइक दिस. बुलाओ फोर्थ का कोई बच्चा. कोई गर्ल बुला के. क्या मुश्किल थी इसमें? यू रिक्वायर ओनली इंसल्ट एंड दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट इज डन बाय मी. व्हेन यू आर नॉट एबल टू एक्सप्रेस द थिंग्स इन इंग्लिश ना, इन नाइन्थ क्लास आई हैव कॉल्ड सो मेनी टाइम्स इन माय प्रीवियस क्लासेस जूनियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड दे वर एबल टू फ्रेम. दे वर फीलिंग सो रिलीव्ड बिकॉज टू कीप सच अ बिग बियर एट होम. It really required lots of efforts. It required a lot of efforts. But now they were relieved from that. Yes, he was grown up in size. It was very difficult to keep him in a house. But now they were missing him. But now he has gone. And they were feeling relaxed because now there was no need to look after such a big animal at house. Because it was not an easy task. Yes, sit down. Okay, now you are also not supposed to do second part in your fear notebook. You will be doing only in books. Yes. You will be doing these three questions in your notebook. On two occasions, Bruno ate, drank something that should not be eaten drunk. What happened to him and on these occasions? These occasions were discussed in detail. So I'm going to ask from online, my favorite student, they always are active, Dhiren and Daljeet. So Dhiren, you tell me first.
Yes, ma'am. Bruno was a big sloth bear which was growing in size and was quite notorious and mischievous. He usually drank a lot of things and ate a lot of things that should not be eaten by a sloth bear. Firstly, the narrator's wise game is anything that could go down with his neck in relish. And one day he accidentally ate barium carbonate, which is a very dangerous poison and which paralyzed him. And the doctor has to give him 3 antidotes to bring him to the good state. And second, he drank about a gallon of old engine oil, and a lot of it was taken inside, but it didn't have any effect on him.
Afterwards, I'm going to call Riza and Vanshika. They will stand in front of camera and they will be telling me the answer in detail, because in this answer, you are required to tell me the answer in detail, the whole of the incident, actually what happened. And I'm not going to provide you any kind of hint in this answer, because while explaining the chapter, I explained these incidents in detail. And I told you also such kind of questions are very much important. They can be asked to narrate such incidents when he ate poison. Okay? Yes, oil was not eaten, it was drunk. In your opinion, it was eaten. Oil cannot be eaten. Yes, barium carbonate, it was eaten. So after that, I'm going to ask Daljeet. Then offline students, you just be ready. Yes, Daljeet, you tell me. Yes, Daljeet, start speaking. Daljeet, your voice is not audible. What happened? We are not able to listen to you. Okay, now Riza is coming. Fast. Riza, we are not free like you. Please come here. I don't know. Come here. Because whenever I explain the chapter, Reza is always busy. She doesn't listen at all. She doesn't prepare any notes. She doesn't write whatever the details I discuss in the class. Her main motive is to only talk and talk to Vanshika and convey whatever she wants to. But she looks at you. She is so eager to tell you something always. This is the reason you keep on standing in my class. Only 4 or 5 students are raising their hands. What about others? These are the 2 important incidents of the chapter. When his life was in danger. So what was the first one? When he has taken barium carbonate. It was just like a poison. It was a poison which was kept in library to kill mice and rats. And second, and why so much ginger oil was kept? Because of termites. Because termites were increasing, and it was kept to kill termites. So this answer, you, Pranshi, you come. Pranshi, you come and tell me this answer. Deemak.
One day narrator ported a barium carbonate. One day a narrator put a poison barium carbonate to kill rats and mice in the library. Bruno entered the library as he often did, and he ate some poison. Another time he found nearly 1 gallon of old engine oil when he drank from a slump of the slide barker and was keeping a weapon against the inroads of
I don't want to listen bookish language, first of all. It doesn't mean that you keep book in front of you and give me answer. Write down in your own words. Move. Arvind, you come. Arvind, you come. You haven't framed in your own words. You are sitting idle, taking rest. Sufficient time is given to you. By that time, you can write down in class. But no. They sit so free. They are on bed rest, I think so. In English class, bachche, if you really want to improve your English, you have to move your pens also. You have to write down. You require written practice. First of all, I think he should learn models. Can I give answer to speak this sentence in front of a teacher? Grammatically, is it right or not? Why me? And I think this thing is taught in class 2nd or 3rd. Okay, Jaskira, 2-3 lines. I want only 2-3 lines. Hurry up. So, ek hi suna do. Sunao to sahi. नहीं मैं पीसी उठा के वहां आ जाती हूँ.
Bruno oftenly enters the library. So he did that day. There kept a poison barium carbonate to kill rats and mice that entered into his library. Bruno accidentally ate that poison. Obviously, eating of that poison affect him by paralysis. He cannot stand on his own, but he managed to drag himself on his terms to his wife, who called narrator for the solution.
Well tried. Now you tell me the answer.
The narrator put down barium carbonate to kill rats and mice, but it was accidentally eaten by Baba. It was a poison. The second incident was that the weapon to kill termites was the engine oil. And Baba promptly drank 1 gallon of engine oil.
So these were the two incidents. When he ate or drank something that should not be eaten. Okay, and you have to tell in detail actually what happened to him on those occasions. Okay, now next question we have is, was Bruno a loving and playful pet? Yeah. Then why he have to be sent away? If he was so loving, if he was so playful, so what was the reason to be sent him away? Why he was sent in that zoo? I'm so happy. My hard work really paid. It's enough. Arnold is going to tell the answer. No problem. Nobody is going to see the recording. मैं पकड़ के खड़ी हूँ माइक।
Yes, Bruno was a loving and playful pet. He did a few tricks. He would wrestle or box and tumble. He would hold gun in the form of a stick and point at a person. However, it was becoming difficult to keep him at home. Therefore, he had to send away.
So whatever he has written, it was absolutely right because he has told each trick of a child. When it was a baby bear, when it was treated like just like a child, which kind of you can say tricks he was doing in home, everybody was enjoying. But afterwards, what happened? It was growing. Its size was increasing. Okay, it was difficult to be handled. Moreover, there was a risk for two Alsatians, dogs and the children of tenants. Moreover, its size was becoming huge. Okay, so that's why it was very difficult to manage him and to stay it in the home. So that's why he has to be sent away. How was the problem of what to do with Bruno finally solved? When his size was increasing, he was not to be kept at one place. Okay. There was a problem to keep him in the bungalow. So what was the problem? How the problem was solved?
I don't know. He was
acting. Yes. How was the problem? Because earlier he was sent to zoo. But on the request of his wife, he was brought back. Okay. And how the problem was solved? By making an
island.
So this answer will be spoken by Simran. You come. Now you are all supposed to do these three answers in your fair notebooks tomorrow. And tomorrow bring your notebooks for checking. Yes. Tomorrow all of you give me a notebooks for checking.
Bruno was the orphanage bear brought by the narrator at home. Bruno was becoming large day by day. And his appetite was really large. He used to eat literally everything. So Bruno was really difficult to keep at home due to its size. So the first time they sent him to a zoo, but they missed him very much. So he was brought back. And then an island was made for him to keep him warm.
So we will continue this chapter tomorrow.